Uh-oh, you just spent all this time on a project. You are close to rendering, and now, for some reason, this happens. Some of your materials are this pinkish purple color. Where did your materials go? I understand the panic you might be feeling, but fear not. In most cases, this is a very easy fix. And there's something you can do to avoid having this problem in the future. You see, with these materials, Blender links some data from outside files unless you tell it otherwise. It does this so that the blend file doesn't get too large. But the problem with this is that Blender isn't really saving the information. It's just telling itself where to find it when it needs it. And if your file paths change, so if you move the material textures or you move the blend file, Blender no longer knows where it's supposed to look for this stuff. So if you moved either of these files, the pinkish purple tells you that Blender can't find your stuff. All you need to do is tell Blender where to look for the files again. What you need to do is go to File, External Data, Find Missing Files. Blender will prompt you to show where it looks for these missing files. Navigate to a folder where you know your files are, and this can be anywhere in the hierarchy of files, but the more files that Blender has to search through to find what it's looking for, the longer it will take. This is a good reason to keep all of your materials and texture files in one general location. The more files Blender has to look through, the longer it takes to find it. In this case, it took me about a minute. And voila, your materials are all back to normal. To avoid this problem in the future, you can tell Blender to pack the files it needs inside of the blend file. This will make the blend file larger, but it is necessary if you want all your files to stay with the scene, especially if you plan on sharing it or trying to access this file from a different computer. To do this, you simply go to File, External Data, Pack All into .blend. Also, you can tell Blender to do this automatically from now on by selecting Automatically Pack into .blend. One other tip, avoid changing the names of your textures and material files after you start using them. Changing the name of the material files after you use it will keep Blender from being able to find it, and this trick won't help you in that situation. Thank you for watching. If this was helpful, please like the video and consider subscribing for more tips.